Hi, Neil here with Puzzling Parts. Today I'm going to be doing something a little bit different. Not quite a review as such, but I picked up a couple of Bruce Vinney's puzzle boxes. There's a company which does laser cut pieces who does kits of his boxes. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and make up Hadrian's box. So it comes with a set of pretty good instructions. You get several pages worth of how-tos, so something like this. And I'm going to go through and make that. I'm going to try and do something a little bit interesting, and we'll do it all as time-lapse. So hopefully in round about 15 minutes, you'll be able to see me build a box from nothing into a fully working puzzle box. Okay, enjoy.
Thank you. I could sleep.
So you watched me playing at the end there, trying to put the box together, and unfortunately failing quite dramatically. So what actually happened is, if we have a look at the box, so we'll take the top panel off. On this end, hopefully you can see this runner here. So I peeled this off at the end, this little guy. This drops into the far side, so if I bring this back up, let me see. Let me just take that panel out. So, there we go. So, yeah, there we go. This is the right-hand side panel. And etched into the top of it, there's two grooves where this runner sits. And this is designed to stop the top panel, there we go, from being removed from the box without having to use the relevant sliders. Unfortunately, what's happened is when I put this in order to shut the box, when this is all flush in the inside, so right inside here, hopefully the light's good enough, maybe not. Yeah, there we go. You can see if that's proud. So this should sit absolutely flush with the top here, and the idea is that the sliders on either side, this should be able to push backwards. Unfortunately, it doesn't. If I shift, let's see, there we go. If I shift the box this side, lift it up slightly, you'll see that the slider now moves. So, the slider moves, but if you look at the very edge of the box, it's now high. What that means, if I put this piece back in, is it's now no longer in line. You can see it there quite easily. It's no longer in line with the rest of the lid for the box. Yeah, there we go. So that's actually too high. As a result, I can't actually put the box together. What I believe has happened, if I open this up again, is when you put all this together, you'll see there's a couple of pins either side. These help you align this whole stack. So we have a stack of three pieces here. And what I believe has happened is when this walnut end panel has been laser cut, the two notches that these pegs drop into are just slightly too low, slightly too high. They're offset, whichever way you work is. Which means that this panel, rather than sitting absolutely spot on, is actually sitting slightly high. So unfortunately, none of this lines up, and the box won't shut. So I did actually get in touch with the company that does it, BH Pen and Laser Crafts. I got in touch with them, and the chap there very kindly said, yep, not a problem, he will send me out the replacement parts for the end, so I'll be able to remake this section, finish the box up, and we should be good. So thanks very much to Bob over at B&H Pen and Laser for agreeing to send me the parts. Hopefully now that you've seen that, you now know what I was talking about. All in all, really good puzzle box, really quite like it. I'm quite impressed by it. So, nice kit. If you're thinking about getting one, B&H Pen and Laser is not a bad place to go. Their kit's pretty good. So, yeah. Thanks for watching.